for joining us. And the new founder, Sanjay, with Nitin, Soni of Fitch Ratings, and Sanjay, Chawla of CNBC-TV18. But first up, Reema, what's at stake for various companies in that?
Well, not for any pre-qualified bidders. The key to track will be parting Vodafone Idea, Reliance Communications, as well as Jio, out of which four of them that parting Vodafone and Idea and Reliance Communications have spectrum which comes out to the news. Now, off the list this year is Idea, which is most vulnerable. It is in the 900 MHz spectrum. They have a spectrum which comes out to the news in 9 seconds, which contributes 72% to the company's cost revenue. Out of those 9 circuits for Idea, they have a backup in the form of 1800 MHz in 7 circuits. But in 2 of them, that will be West as well as Gujarat, which contributes about 13-15% to its revenue. They have no backup. So it's quite important that Idea is going to be. The 72% of its cost revenue is at stake, and that makes Idea the most vulnerable. Margin is still relatively delicate. Spectrum renewal in 6 circles in the 900 MHz, that contributes 34% to its cost revenue, but they have backup in all the 3 circles. And but interestingly, Parsley has actually deposited more on its money than Idea. So clearly, they're looking to buy a lot more than what comes up to renew. Reliance Communications is interesting because they have spectrum renewal in 7 circles. They contribute 28% to their cost revenue. But in 4 of those 7 circles, they lost their number one, number two, and number three player. And due to the fact that Reliance Communications is struggling with a high debt, will the company go ahead and try and renew the spectrum where it's not even as near about 1 or 2 or 3 players? And that's the true question. If it doesn't, then those 8 circles will open up for the other players to acquire. So where here will be the surprise factor, so the only earnest money, which is the popular buy type for the healthy option, the strong asset guarantee, where they save more than the others. So the same amount is 4,500 crores, they will serve the path of retail guesses.
All right, let's find out what all this means for the financial of the telecom companies, and therefore that's not Republican for the interest reading, and Sanjay Chawla of the financial joining us. Looking at that scene, as Reema has just laid out, that Idea, Party, and maybe Vodafone are the three that are likely to be impacted the most, even more qualified for the decisions which were here in India. What is your take on the impact on financials, the kind of spend that Idea and Party may have to put up to be able to retain their circles?
Even after the $500 in new options, the thousand network with 3,000 to 3,500. Well, I think you may think that even after the auction, the number may be below 2.5 times 7. So already made about $22.5 million from the Rakuten Tower sale, and there is a likely to run half a sale as well. We have in mind that when we are out there, we propose to pay 25% of
$7,800.
And it's a general payment of 10 years. Yes, correct. So they're not paying up front for the money, they're only paying
23%. Mr. Chawla, good afternoon. This is Reema here. So, I'm aware of you, the likes of Idea and Party, are likely to give you this section 900 megahertz. What happens if we cannot give it to you? What if the price is too high and you can give off a new 900 megahertz? Then perhaps you will have to rely on some other, frequency bands for the continuity of your operation. So, in that case, what will be the incremental spend? And then we will also do an assessment of, companies like Idea as well as Party, in the event they do not manage to win.
I think that situation is unlikely. Most of the circles they are already in the 900, they should be able to deploy it. Because of that, they have a lot of financial firepower, and they have the most income sector, and they are more tested. So, regardless of the fact that we could have the three top operators in the Reliance company, all these four regional operators are coming, are in the group. Maybe some kind of, competitive equilibrium, which means more exporting to the regional sector, as well as the regional sector, etc. The only risk is that from the last year, because we do not have a high-quality frequency band, they may go up to 900, perhaps not to acquire it, but maybe just push it to buy for other operators. That is a risk, and, we think that, first of all, the first strategy will be if the price goes too high, the first thing that these companies will do is to reduce the quantity of it. Typically, we have an operator with 7 megahertz of 900 spectrum in the circles, they may just reduce to their minimum 5 megahertz. So that is one way to actually continue your operations, whether to your particular spectrum, and also put a cap on your total spectrum length. Other than that, it is also very high.
Lead them to a higher level of 3.5 times 0.
that would be
the only question on our side, which I think both of you agree is likely to be least effective on the amount of spend on this. So, do you need to get the clear for the speaker?
Yeah, I think our conscience is the least effective. They should pay about $50 to $67 million, giving their $7 million that is high, and most of it are. Which, you know, in terms of contribution to the reserve, it's a more contribution to the capital that's come with the option of these. Maybe you might find it a bit difficult to remove the spectrum of the FDA cycle, but I think that I think it should be okay for them.
Okay, so a final 10-second question. Eventually, all the spectrum costs will get passed on to consumers, which are prepared to clarify.
Thank you.